بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وأصحابه ومن والاه أما بعد. This is our fifth lesson going through the principles of Warsh and Qalun. على شرح لمنظومة الدرر اللوامع في أصل مقرأ الإمام نافع authored by Ibn Berri رحمه الله. We stopped at the statement of the author, القول في الخلاف في ميم الجميع مقرب المعنى مهذب بديع. And so in this chapter we're going to discuss the خلاف between Warsh and Qalun concerning the ميم الجمع, the ميم that denotes plurality, وهو, and it's defined as الميم الزائدة الدالة على جماعة المذكرين. It is the meme, an extra meme, right, that denotes the masculine plural. عليكم, upon you, plural. So the meme here is what denotes the plurality. And generally speaking, this meme bil jam' usually comes before four letters. That is the ha, the kaf, the hamza, and the ta. For example, antum, antum. Another example, مثلا أأنذرتهم, see the hat this time, مثلا عليكم, so the kaf, and then you have one case in which it comes after the hamza, هاء مقرأ كتابي, هاء, this meme here is meme, الجمع, طيب, and so here the author says I'm going to speak about the khilaf concerning meme الجمع, and when we're talking about meme الجمع, we talk about it from three angles, and we're looking at it from what comes after it. That's 2 points, and then 1 point will be how to stop on it. So that's the 3 points that I discussed. So when we're talking about what comes after it, what can come after it can either be a non-hamzat wasl, right? A non-hamzat wasl, or a hamzat wasl. That is what can come after it. So when we have a non-hamzat wasl, it means we're talking about essentially a mutaharrik, right? What comes after it is a mutaharrik. And this mutaharrik can be of two types, a hamzat qatr and a non-hamzat qatr, right? And then you have the second one, which is the when the mim al-jam' is followed up with a hamzat wasl. And then had al-waqf, when you're stopping on the mim al-jam', what options do you have? Can you stop on it with this kind of nahf? Can you also incorporate ishmam and ram? So that's what the author discusses in this chapter. طيب قال المصنف وصل ورش ضم ميم الجمع إذا أتت من قبل همز القطع. So the author begins with the madhab of Warsh. And the madhab of Warsh is that the meme al-jama' you add a silah to it, and of course this silah we'll see in the next chapter, that in a few chapters time, that it will be elongated 6 harakat. It's a silah, and we call it maddu silah. And so what he does is that when you have the meme al-jama' and what comes after it is a hamzat qat' meaning not a hamzat wasl, and not a non-hamzat qat' meaning a hamzat qat'. For example, مثلا أأنذرتهم أأنذرتهم أم لم, right? So the hamza qata comes after it, right? عليكم أنفسكم. You see the hamza comes after the meme الجمع. This is hamza qata, and we should know already the difference between hamza qata and hamza wasl. So if a hamza qata comes after the meme الجمع, the meme الجمع is elongated with a sila, and this elongation will be 6 harakat. And so you'll say عليكم أنفسكم أنذرتهم أم. You see, and so وصل ورش ضم ميم الجمع إذا أتت من قبل همز القطع. And so what Warsh does when you have a ميم الجمع and what comes after is a همز القطع. Of course, ميم الجمع always occurs at the end of the word. ميم الجمع always ends at the end, always occurs at the end of the word. And so when the ميم الجمع is followed by a همز القطع, we say Warsh will do what? ضمهم نميم, and then الصلة after it. طيب. As for قالون, we'll see the author mentions وكلها سكنها قالون. And so when it comes to قالون, قالون قرأ بالإسكان. So it doesn't matter whether what comes after is a همزة قطع or a non-همزة قطع. طيب. So when it comes to Warsh, if it's a non-همزة قطع, مثلا أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. So here what comes after the جمع is a lam. Here you won't see Warsh doing a صلة. Rather, he will say أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمْ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ, right? And قَالُون is the same. قَالُون, whether what comes after is a hamzat qat' or a non-hamzat qat', he will apply وَجْهُ الْإِسْكَانِ. This is what the author mentioned. And so قَالُون would say إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. See? سكون on the ميم الجمع. Whereas Warsh will say إن الذين كفروا سواء عليهم أنذرتهم أم لم تنذرهم لا يؤمنون. That's how Warsh would read it. So when we have the mutaharrik coming after the mim al-jam', the madhab of Warsh, if the mutaharrik is a hamzat qat', then we do silah. If it's a mutaharrik but not hamzat qat', then we don't do silah. That's Warsh. As for Qalun, whether it's a hamzat qat' or a non-hamzat qat', we do what? We do iskan upon the mim al-jam' and no silah. Of course, this is according to the author rahimahullah. And this is generally what the maghariba are upon. So when it comes to the madhab of Qalun, the chosen madhab that the Maghariba are upon is that they just take the wajhul iskan. However, we've taken in al-Shatibi and we should know that min tariq al-Shatibi and min tariq al-Nashit al-Marwazi, there is what? Two awjuh for Qalun. Qalun has wajhul silah and also adam al-silah, right? Qalun has adam al-silah and he also has al-silah as well. طيب. And this madhab of the Maghariba is also chosen by Ibn Mujahid al-Ta'i, right? Ibn Mujahid al-Ta'i, the student of Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, right? He chose the madhab as well of the madhab that the author rahimahullah mentioned here. وَكُلُّهَا سَكَّنَهَا قَالُونُ. So however, we know from al-Shatibi that Qalun has two awjuh. Qalun has al-Silah wa adam al-Silah. And so Qalun can recite with Silah, and the Silah applies across the board, whether it be a Hamzat Qatah coming after it or another Mutaharrik coming after it. So in the same example we gave a few minutes ago, the second wajah of Qalun would be إِنَّ الَّذِينَ كَفَرُوا سَوَاءٌ عَلَيْهِمُ أَنذَرْتَهُمُ أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمُ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ. So he would apply the Silah. We know Surah Al-Fatiha, صِرَاطَ الَّذِينَ أَنْعَمْتَ عَلَيْهِمُ غَيْرِ الْمَغْضُوبِ عَلَيْهِمُ. That's how Qalun would read it. طيب, of course, waslan. That's the second wajah, right, which the author did not mention here. طيب. And then he says, وَكُلُّهَا سَكَنَهَا قَالُونُ مَا لَمْ يَكُمْ مِنْ بَعْدِهَا سُكُونُ. Of course, what's coming after the mim must not be a sakin. It must not be a sakin. طيب, if it is a sakin, then we go on to the next one that the author mentions, وَاتَّفَقَ فِي ضَمِّهَا فِي الْوَصْلِ إِذَا أَتَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِ هَمْزِ الْوَصْلِ. We know that what comes after, usually the mim al-jam', if it's a sakin, will be hamz al-wasl. Like مثلاً, بِهِمُ الْأَسْبَابِ. بِهِمُ الْأَسْبَابِ. Here, this mim al-jam', what comes after it is a hamz al-wasl. And of course, the hamz al-wasl is affirmed when you are beginning from it, when you are of course removing it, it's removed. Or when you are conjoining it, when you are conjoining the two words, it's of course removed, right, as we should know. And so, if the hamzat wasl is what comes after the mim al-jam', we say that we recite the mim al-jam' with what? With a dhammah waslan. With a dhammah waslan. For who? Both Warsh and Qalun. Wattafaqa. It's alif al-ithnain. So it applies to Nafi' as a whole and Warsh and Qalun specifically. طيب. And so they'll say what? Bihimul asbab alayhimul qital. طيب. And so that's how you read it for Warsh and Qalun. So the kasra upon the ha and dhamma upon the meem. You won't say alayhim al-qital, you won't say alayhum al-qital, that you'll say alayhim al-qital, just like you would for Hafs. Naam. Then the author, he says, وَكُلُّهُمْ يَقِفُ بِالْإِسْكَانِ وَفِي الْإِشَارَةِ لَهُمُ قَوْلَانِ. So now he's going on to the third mas'ala, which is the mas'ala to al-waqfi ala meem al-jam'. When you are stopping on the meem al-jam', how do you stop on it? The asr is, of course, wal-iskanu, asr al-waqfi. So the asl, when you are stopping on a word, you stop on it with what? As-sukun al-mahf. And so you say, عَلَيْهِمْ أَأَنذَرْتَهُمْ أَمْ لَمْ تُنذِرْهُمْ هُمْ. طيب, iskan, mahf. طيب, وَفِي الْإِشَارَةِ لَهُمُ قَوَانِ. Al-ishara here refers to the Roman and the ishmam. The Roman and the ishmam. So when it comes to the ishara, the ishara meaning al-raf will be al-rom or al-ishmam, then this can come into play because of the fact that there is khilaf concerning whether the meme originally had a dhamma on it or a sukun on it. And this is of course applicable only when there is a silah in play. And so for Warsh, this would only be applicable when there is a silah. For example, in مثلاً عَلَيْهِمُ أَنْذَرْتَهُمْ. طيب. So عَلَيْهِمُ, here there's a silah, right? And the silah comes from the dhamma, right? Because the waw is usually born from the dhamma, right? And so was this dhamma there initially or is it the initial sukun, right? So is the sukun al-arad or is the sukun asli? There's a khilaf. If this asl, which is madhmum, and the sukun is an aarad, then yajuzu fiha al-rum wal-ishmam, right, as we've taken before, right, in al-muqaddimah al-jazariyah. طيب. And so that's why there is not khilaf between the qurra or the qurra in this case. And of course for Qalun, his second wajah is where the khilaf would also apply. Of course for Qalun in the first wajah, he doesn't have any silah, and so for him it will be what? Sukun mahad. And so there won't be any application of a rom or an ishmam. طيب. And so the author says وفي الإشارة لهم قولان أي لورش وقالون, they have what? Two ways, meaning affirm the rom and the ishmam or remove the rom and the ishmam. Then he mentions the tarjih by saying وتركها أظهر في القياس وهو الذي ارتضاه جل الناس, in the majority, and that which is more correct, and that is the method of Abu Amr al-Dani, right, the tahqiq of Abu Amr al-Dani, is that you get rid of the rom and the ishmam, and rather you apply what? الوقف, الوقف بالسكون المحض. طيب وترك أظهر في القياس وهو الذي ارتضاه جل الناس. So most of the قراء, most of the أئمة, they chose and they were pleased with more the قراءة of السكون المحف as opposed to the روم and the إشمام. And so you just say عليهم, right, مثلا on عليهم and ارتضاهم وقفا, you say what? عليهم, and you won't apply وجه الروم أو والإشمام. طيب, and of course we should know what الروم and الإشمام are, and we'll see it later as well. The author has a specific chapter in Bab al-Waqf tackling that mas'ala as well. هذا والله أعلم. We've come to the end of this chapter. And so we'll stop here بإذن الله. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت أستغفرك وأتوب إليك, والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.